Hey roomies, welcome back. This is Intuitive Mara doing the next video. I figured I'd do it separately. So, people who just want to focus on contour got that out of the way. People want to focus on the fun other makeup stuff, that's fine. Figured it'd just be easier for everybody. That way you don't have to go on and on and on and on in one video. So yeah, hopefully you guys left your comments for the previous video, the contour video. Okay, so this is Intuitive Mara. Some of you have seen me on Oranum. I apologize, my video likes to have fun with the focus sometimes. So let's do this real quick. There we go. So there we go. Okay. If you guys are wondering about the music in my background, I'm actually listening to one of many of my playlists that I have or that I follow on YouTube here on Intuitive Mara on my page. So that's what's playing in the background if anyone was curious, because there's some old school, new school stuff. So if you like it, you can always, follow those if you want. That's fine. Okay, so let's get started. What we're gonna do in this video is more of the fun, makeup stuff. So, I'm trying to make sure I had everything. I just forgot one teensy-weensy thing, but I think it's here. It's probably just under my desk here, real quick. Here it is. What I'm going to be doing, okay, in this video is I'm going to be doing blush. I got back into blush. I was never really big on blush, but now I'm back into that. Also, I will be showing between the blush, I'll be showing brow pencil. Brow pencil. I was never really big on brow pencil. I did used to do it back in college, but then I think the one I had used, I didn't care for it after a while. It wasn't as exact, and it just wasn't as important to me at the time, honestly, running around all the time. So, I didn't do it for a while. So I just got back into it recently over the summer because I always thought that if you pluck or wax, however you do it, or thread your brows perfectly, I figured you don't need to have a brow pencil, right? You wouldn't need one, right? If you do it right, the shaping of your eyebrow, then it's perfect. You don't have to worry about it. Well, though that can be true to an extent, I have learned being in some of the makeup groups, I've learned that even though you can shape your brows perfectly, honestly, even if it's perfect, the brow pencils really do help emphasize a more clean look. So you think it's a clean look, you can make it look even cleaner by filling it in so that it looks more solid, not so sparse. And also, brow pencils are obviously beneficial for if you overplucked or maybe your hair is starting to not grow back as much and you need that part filled in. Obviously, brow pencils are beneficial for those individuals as well. So we've all been through it. When we go through life, we end up overplucking or underplucking or whatever. This is your savior. Some people like to do with the old-fashioned pencil way, which I actually prefer. Some people do the ones that you can actually twist and it goes up. Those are okay. Not to say that they're bad. However, I find that if you put too much pressure on it, it breaks. The actual, formula of your color breaks. And sometimes the little mechanical thing that you turn to make it go up, your stuff up, it can break. Because I've had an issue with that with one of the pencils in the past. So I trust the handy dandy old-fashioned pencil way. It's like a fail-safe. And typically the ends have this little brushy tip, which I actually use as an eraser. So you'll see me use it as an eraser in the video, okay? And then you'll see me use eyeliner. I tend to use liquid eyeliner because I'm an oily skin type. Liquid eyeliner stays on me virtually all day. Even if it's not waterproof, it still stays on me all day versus using a pencil. So that's kind of a personal preference at that point, depending how your skin is with the product. For me, oily skin, I gotta go with liquid eyeliner. For me, it's more precise. It doesn't come off within 5 minutes, whereas the pencil did for me, no matter what brand it was, in passing, granted. And I like that it's bolder. I like a little bolder. I like a true black. So, you know, if you're like me in that sense, then you'll like this. So, and I'll also do the mascara as well, and lippies. I'll do the lip stuff, the lipstick or lip gloss, whatever. And eyes, I'm debating if I want to do eyes, to be honest, because I just showered, and usually when I just shower, sometimes I don't feel like doing the extra eyeshadow. Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. So let's see how I feel after the majority of the video has been concluded. So let me show you the quick products real quick. So for brow pencil in this video, I'll be using Flawless Brow Pencil. The color is medium. It's a BH Cosmetic pencil. I always get their stuff on sale, which their stuff's already cheap, so if the fact you can get it cheaper, if you keep track of their deals, are amazing. So that's what I'm using, and it's the regular pencil one, not the mechanical one. Mechanical ones I do not trust. I might try it again, but I'm apprehensive about it. Eyeliner. Liquid eyeliner I'll be using in the video is Almay liquid eyeliner, the black color. Okay, the Almay. Little big ol' lay there. Just a quick note, I tend to use the Almay one because the liquid eyeliners, they're all different as far as the application is concerned. This one specifically, it has a spongy tip. Okay, I don't know if you can see it or not, but it has a spongy tip. Maybe I can move it so you can see it. Maybe it's a spongy tip. So, I find that a liquid eyeliner that has a spongy tip makes the application process much easier, much more to the point, and you don't have to worry about the little brush hairs fraying, you know, or getting out of place. So I actually like this. Now, if you need something to hold you over, maybe you ran out and you're getting ready to go to party real quick, and let's say you don't have cash on you, or just something real quick or budget conscious, you can go to the dollar store and get the liquid eyeliners. Now, granted, most of the ones they have are the hair bristle ones, the little brush ones. However, if you're stuck in a bind or financially tight, the liquid eyeliner actually does do a good job. Just gotta be careful applying because if you're used to a sponge tip, or maybe you're new to using eyeliner, you might want to practice a little bit. But it's a great safety net if you're stuck in a bind or whatever. The dollar store one's fine. I use it sometimes just to hold me over, and it's totally fine. Okay, it's all about how you apply it. Okay, so I just thought I'd emphasize that. As far as doing the eyes, I actually put two out. Since I'm home, I usually use like these clear ones. I know it doesn't look clear right now. It's the Natural Lash. This is good for women who are not big on adding much makeup, or just don't want much on. Yeah, if you don't want much on, or you want the natural look, you don't really want all the black, this is actually really good, surprisingly. The reason why it looks gray, just to explain, to explain myself, is because sometimes, like I'll have my black mascara on, and like when I try to wash it off, sometimes a little bit's accidentally left over. So when I put this on, it accidentally gets some of the black, which honestly I don't mind because basically it makes this go from clear to gray, which is like a little bit of color, but not much. And I use it for home just so I'm not wasting this at home as much. So it just depends on the mood. I mean, sometimes I'll use this, sometimes I'll use this, whatever. But yeah, that one works. That's Professional Natural Lash. I actually got this at the dollar store. CoverGirl. It's CoverGirl, and it's the clear one. I know it doesn't look clear in this video, but it is clear when you buy it. Okay, so that's good for if you're not big on that. Now, as far as actual mascara, almost forgot the word. In this video, I'll probably end up using this one, I think. Just to show you. I'm going to use the Colossal Chaotic Lash Volume Express, the waterproof one from Maybelline. I tend to get Maybelline as far as mascara is concerned. There's like one or two other brands I like, but this is like my fave. No matter which one I pick, 9 times out of 10, I like it, as long as it's the thick brush. I like the thick brush specifically because I like my lashes long and bold. I don't like them really thin and like barely showing. Okay, I like it a nice thick bold lash. So for the unique ladies out there, yes, I know your products are great. I know I heard some great stuff, which I'll probably try some anyway at some point. But I can't lie, I don't need to use the $20-$30 one when I can get this for $7, if that, and get the same effects. It works for me. Now, I'm not saying it's gonna work for everybody. Everyone's different with eyelashes, but for me, thankfully, it works. So it works just like the unique one, so I don't have to buy that one. So I've been blessed and fortunate to be able to utilize, you know, a cheaper one. But they are good. I have heard they're good. So that's what I'll be using, okay? And then lip wise, I'll probably do, I have so many different colors. I'm all about the lippies. I think that is my guilt trip, is the lippies. That's my fave. I think I'm gonna go ahead and do, I was debating between red or reddish brown color. I have all types. I have the, I love the matte lipsticks. So whether it's the lipstick or the liquid lipstick, I like anything matte that's gonna last for hours. And even if you did have to apply it, which you shouldn't have to, but even if you did, it's only like one time, you know, like minimal. I did try these new matte ones that were like a buck each. You buy three, get one free through eBay. This is a company overseas. They're really, really cheap. So granted, even though these are great, they actually are great, but you have to put like three layers on. So just be mindful, you will have to use quite a few layers. But it actually really is great for something to tie you over. So this is something that's good to tie you over, okay? So yeah, so I have that. The one I was showing earlier, I have different colors. ColourPop, I actually fell in love with ColourPop. I've done research out the butt on a lot of these products before even buying, because I want to know what I'm getting into when I purchase a product. So I look at all the YouTube videos, etc. So I was finally sold after enough research. And I actually really do like them. So that's ColourPop, the liquid matte lipsticks. They have like so many great colors. Now for an actual thicker, waxier lipstick versus the liquid one, is the BH Cosmetics Color Lock Collection. It's like $4 or $5. Sometimes they have it on sale even cheaper if they have a special deal. It's an actual lipstick versus ColourPop's liquid one. They do have, just now, they just came out, BH Cosmetics, with a liquid one, which I'll try. I haven't yet. I will try it. It just came out. But since they didn't have it at the time, I went with ColourPop. So I still like BH, but ColourPop had it first. So that's where I went. But yeah, their actual lipsticks are really nice and really affordable, and they do work very well, actually. This is the Color Lock, okay? And I have different colors for that as well. The only thing that I would say with these, because remember it's a matte, is especially if you're new using things like this, take your time applying it. Because since this is an actual lipstick and it's more waxy, whereas this is really light and thin, you know, and actually a little bit easier to apply, you want to take your time putting it on. So you just got to get used to it. But it'll be worth it once you get the hang of putting it on. Just, you know, I'd rather you be safe and do it slow at first so you don't mess it up, because remember, this is something that's meant to stay on for hours, okay? So just keep in mind. And you can use lip liner as well for ladies who like to mix it up, which I do need to get lip liner. Another lipstick I use that is really good, which I never really thought about. I just got this on the fly a while back on sale. And I actually end up really liking it. It's a peach color, this one. Something different. It's by L'Oreal Paris. This color is Perpetual Peach 423. L'Oreal Infallible, the actual lipstick. I think they still sell these, last I checked. And you know what? Look, this is all I have left, guys. This is literally all I have left. So I actually really like this, surprisingly. This was one of those that I really didn't think much about, but I just got it because it was on sale. And you know what? I actually really like it. And it does stay on a good while. It's almost like a mix between a lipstick and a lip gloss. It's something that's like light, easy. You put it on real quick. It's smoother, And I love it actually. I didn't think I'd be that big into it, but apparently I am. So I'll have to get some at some point. This is a new recent, which I had to share with you ladies. A new recent purchase, and I only got it because it was on sale. Because right now it's been a little bit hard for everybody financially, so I only got it because it was on clearance. The company is called Gerard Cosmetics. Color Your Smile. And let me tell you, I only ordered one just to try them out first to see if I even like them. Because it was a little bit of an investment money-wise to get the product. But you know what? They packaged it very well. Let me tell you, it literally looks like a legit gift box. It's like someone had a present already packed for you. The presentation was amazing from this company, and I only ordered one thing, this. Okay? And I was actually impressed with the quality and how they were good with the service, the promptness, everything under the sun. I was actually really impressed. I found this company, these guys, literally on the fly online, just from clicking around, researching one makeup brand, one other, and I just randomly found these guys. So I'm not even sure if they're as popular yet or well known, but they're really good. Their lip stuff tends to run about $25, so that's about similar to some other high quality brands, and it looks like a high quality brand, definitely. But I got it on clearance for $9.40 free shipping this winter. So I saw that, and I really want to try, more brands. But I gotta keep track of my piggy bank too, right? So I thought to myself, I might as well grab one since it was on clearance, because that's the kind of company I just found out. I don't know if they do sales often or not. So that was kind of my chance. 940 versus, $25 with shipping's even included. So, I had to snag it. So I did. So I got the Pretty Penny is the color. It's like an orangey color. Gerard Cosmetics. I actually might end up putting this one on, I don't know. Yeah, and this one is technically a lip gloss. Okay, this isn't the matte lipstick. This is considered a lip gloss, but it's like lipstick, honest to God, because of how the color is so like pigmented and everything. They actually give you a mirror literally on it. Isn't that pretty, guys? Really pretty, right? Now, you think that's cool and I got it for $9, okay? Instead of paying the full price, because I always want to find a sale. I gotta show you this before I start. You gotta check this out. Hopefully you can see it. Let's see here. I know I got a lot of lights going on, so you might not see it. I'll try to lower. Let me lower the lighting here just to give you an idea. Hopefully you can see it more. There's lights under there, guys. I don't know if you can see that, the lights. You see it? There's lights under there. It's like built in. So if you're in the car, maybe in the passenger seat, maybe you came home or you came home from work and then you had to go in, change real quick, whatever, to go to the movies with your hubby or whatever, and assuming you have this, and you need to do a quick brush up with the lip stuff, it has lights. So you're in the car in the dark at night, and your hubby's driving, you just and literally this light is really bright. Okay? And it turns off automatically when you close this properly. It'll turn off. It has like a little button mechanism in it where it'll do that for you. Okay. Might have been hard to see on the video, but it's really cool. So honestly, definitely worth what I paid for. And I didn't even pay a full price. That was in clearance. So now that I've tried a $25 item at less than half the price and liking it, I know for sure I'm gonna get more. And this is considered lip gloss, but it's like a lipstick, okay? And it's good. And it feels nice and soft and everything. So I had to show you that real quick. I'm sure I'll introduce other brands at some point, but my group here is kind of scarce right now. But that's okay. So, That's pretty much the gist of that. I might do eyeshadow, I might not. I might not this time. I'll probably do it in another video. Make it all about the eyeshadow in another video. So let's start with blush. Cheekies. Blush, 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 blush. So I'm going to use my blush brush. The bigger one that I ended up not using in the last video, which I should have used, was for the powder. The one that's a little bit smaller, this one, will be for the actual blush. Okay, so that's my blush I'm using. I know it looks kind of sad right now, doesn't it? But I'm using it. I'm using it. I got back into blush. This one is actually a really cheap one. I don't know if you've heard of it. Marquinhos. This is like one of those cheap blushes that comes in one of those gift makeup box sets you can get people for Christmas, like at Walmart, Kmart. They probably have it at Sally's. It's really cheap, and this is just one of the pieces in the 20-30 piece kits. So you don't have to use expensive stuff, you guys. It's not what you pay as much as it is how you apply it. That's what makes the difference. Now, yeah, there's certain high quality items out there that are worth paying extra for. It depends what your needs are, what's more important to you, makeup wise in the makeup world. So I'm just dabbing this a few times. Mine's more of like a pinkish color. This one won't say the color, since it was all a set. But yeah, that's what I'm using today. I do have a BH Cosmetics one I got for free as a gift for purchasing $20+ worth of stuff, but I'm not using that right now. I'm using this one because I gotta finish this first before I use that one. But they're all good. Everything's good. So what I do is I swirl it on my cheek, and to make sure I don't put too much, I'll actually just go to the other side. So I'll do both cheeks more or less simultaneously, you know, circular motion. You can do it like that if you want. If you think maybe it's not quite enough, granted, you don't want to overdo it. You can actually just tap, 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 and tap, 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 just to make sure I got enough extra right there, you know, and the cheekies. Circular motion, circular motion, la-di-da, la-di-da. I might have overdone it a little bit, but you can always blend that out, too. Let me use my mirror. And this is a mirror I got at the dollar store. This is what I'm using right now. Usually I do this in the bathroom, but that's okay. I do it here too. And I like to go like this and emphasize, brush off a little bit around the face. You really don't need to do that. I just have a habit of doing that. And it actually looks fine, honestly, but that's just one of my quirks. So I apologize for the quirk. So yeah, and you can go like this. Yeah. So that's fine. Okay. You really don't need that much. Okay. Hopefully you can see in the video somewhat a little bit of a blush layer. Probably see it more in person. Okay. So that's blush. Next up. Let's do eyebrows. Brows. Brows. I actually had a client earlier this morning ask me about how I did my brows. And I gave her the tips in my, Rue Moreno under Intuitive Mara. That's me, Intuitive Mara, the smart ass chica. Tries to keep you guys laughing in chat. I do have my own personal website, intuitivemara.com, for those of you who decide you need to speak with me in private about your personal matters. I am a medium, just FYI, if you're open to that stuff. I'm a no nonsense kind of woman, so just let you know, I'm a blunt bee. So just telling you. But yeah, I'll put the link down if needed. But anyway, let's get back to fun makeup stuff. So, okay, it probably looks really light in the video. Probably looks even lighter than light. Probably the lighting. Anyway, we're gonna use what I mentioned earlier, the medium flawless brow pencil, BH Cosmetics, okay? So what I like to do is I'll actually start here in the front to try and fill in a little bit. Everyone's got their own way of doing it. More straight around it. I like it a little bit rounded, but that's just me. And what I'll do is I'll start to fill in a little bit. And then here, I need to kind of build up a little bit here because I kind of overplucked and it's a little too angled, like up here. So I'm actually going to draw in, like to fill it in a little bit. just to like fix that a little. You know, I don't like my eyebrows too thin anymore. I mean, I like them full enough, but not crazy. What I'm doing right here, just so you know, the end tip, the brush tip, that's actually supposed to, which I didn't do, I apologize, bad habit, is you brush it upward, your hair, and then you can go and start doing what I was doing. I just jumped the gun. But I actually use this as an eraser as well. So if you think you accidentally drew a little over, you know, just fix it. I use it literally as an eraser, and it works for me. So I don't know if you ladies do it or not, but it works for me. Here, I'll put this close up a little. So yeah, so I'm gonna do over a little bit, and then I'll carry this throughout the rest of my brow. You know, to fill it, lightly fill it, and go to the tip. Now I'll have to back up so I can see what I'm doing here for a minute, guys. But yeah, just to get the right shape. I tend to do mine rounded. I know not everyone does that. I do. I just prefer it that way. So see if you think you went over or too long, just use this to not just brush your hairs, but just to you know, straighten it up, fix it. You can fix it. That's the good thing. See, this is why I like pencil. You can build it up. You don't have to have it bam, bold in your face, and you're like, oh shit, you know. Excuse my language, I apologize. But that's why I like the pencil. You can build it up. So it's not as scary to do. If you're someone who's being introduced just now to doing brow pencil, it's not a must. But I've noticed it does help make a difference. And the ladies in the beauty groups I've been in, it actually does make a difference. There was a young lady on there who had a time with her eyebrows and was trying to grow them back, and in the meantime was trying to get into pencil around the same time I was starting to get into pencil. Let me tell you, her brows look a hell of a lot better now, and she's still in the process of still growing them out. And you know what? Her brows look amazing now. They don't look as patchy or whatever. So there's one brow. It might actually look a little thicker. I don't know if you can tell or not. It doesn't have to be that thick. It's kind of a personal preference. I don't like them too thick, but you know, just a like healthy, I guess what I consider a healthy thickness of the brow. So there's this brow done. Okay. Doesn't take long and it's good. And I don't like them too dark. That's just me. And technically it should be a lot darker because my natural dark is really, really dark brown. So there's the after. There's the before. I don't know if you can tell much of a difference. Does it look like a difference to you? You can tell me or comment on the video. It probably looks a little thicker, but it looks good. Like it doesn't look bad. And if anything, it made my eye brow look higher, actually. So yeah, so I'll brush this side. Be a good girl and do it right. Brush it up first, you know. And this is good too because then you can pluck whatever little stragglies you got. You know where to pluck. Now see how this one looks kind of like I overplucked. It happens to the best of us. So before, after. It actually does look kind of thick. But I can always fix that. That's okay. That's easy to fix. Okay, so now we're gonna do this side. And I'm actually gonna clean my nose ring real quick. I neglected to do that with my little Q-tip. Q-tip. Just wanted to fix it real quick because it was gonna bug me. Okay, next one. Next one. See, I do it lightly. I try not to do it dark because you don't want it to be too obvious. The point is, when you're doing this, you want it to fix your problem, right? Your problem areas on your brow, while it not looking obvious. Okay, that's kind of the point. If you make it look obvious, then it doesn't look so nice. Some ladies do it a little too dark or a little too obvious, even though it might look nice, the shape, which is great because that's what you want. I find if it's noticeable, then it's really not that great because the whole point is the illusion. Okay. If anyone's wondering as I'm doing this side, I think I did it slightly darker. Is basically this pencil I'm using by BH Cosmetics that I'm using currently. Basically, this does last all day. Okay, this really does last all day. So if you have plans with somebody or whatever, once this is on, you're good to go. I actually do have a setting spray, a makeup setting spray. I'm not going to include it in this video. I tend to use it sparingly. So it lasts a really long time, actually. I just use it more for like special occasions or whatever, or special outings. I don't use it all the time. You can. I just choose not to because I really don't need to, because my makeup stays on most of the day anyway. So I really don't use it if I don't have to. Sorry, I'm getting anal now with looking at this side and this side. but yeah. So if you're into the rounded like I am, this is how I do it. It doesn't have to be rounded, but I tend to like the rounded look better. Plus, I have a rounded face, and people say it does look nicer on me. And you know, I do like and admire Jennifer Lopez and Sandra Bullock, and they tend to do it more rounded, more on the rounded end. So I grew up, you know, influenced by them as well. So that's kind of where I got more of the roundedness. And I think that was like a big thing in the 90s too. Granted, so was the overplucking. We've all been guilty, so have I. I find that when you're stressed out with life or whatever, you tend to end up plucking more than you should. I've noticed that because I've been guilty of it too. So you're not the only one out there. So I have to admit, the brow pencils are helpful for that. Now that I'm back into it, I was really hesitant to get back into it because I didn't want to look like a tattoo on my face, like tattooed brows. You know, like if you have tattooed brows, that's fine, but as long as it looks natural, that's all I ask. You know, for myself especially. So, you know, I want it to look subtle, not overly obvious. But, you know, if you have little to no hair, you have to do is go and work with it the best way you can. You know, you can use foundation to help conceal it to where it doesn't look as obvious. If you're trying to grow your hairs back, that's fine. I just don't like when they're overly painted. So I try my best to follow that rule for myself because it does bug me after a while. So that's the gist of it. May not be perfect right now, but it looks a hell of a lot better than it did before. And you probably see my brows better in the video too. Just trying to not overdo it, but you know how we get sometimes. Their brows, we get a little addicted to, you know, we want to fix everything, right? So okay, I'm gonna force myself to move on from this. I'm gonna try so we can get on to the rest of the stuff in the video. So yeah, so see, it's really easy. You can build it up. That's why I love the old-fashioned pencil way. Okay, I have to pluck a little bit here because I'm looking a little, it needs a little plucking. But yeah, so see, it's easy. I do need to pluck a little bit, but it looks, you know, hopefully it looks better. You let me know. You know, if you have additional tips, you can share additional tips. That's fine. So yeah, now I'm just being anal. But yeah, so there you go. Okay, it's really not that bad, not that scary. Okay, so if you're hesitant about doing the brow pencil, it's really not that bad. It's not. It just literally takes trial and error, practice, what you think's gonna work for you, really, at the end of the day. Okay, but at least it showed you a better idea. I know it's not perfect, there's a little piece there, but that's fine. I'm home anyway, so. But you see how it looks like I actually have brows. Okay, I still like it, like clean line and everything, but it gives you just enough. Okay, so I love these guys. I'll have to order more from them. Okay, so that's the brows. Next up, what do we want to do here? Let's go ahead and do the lip because I'm tired of looking at my bare lips. I know that's usually like the last thing, but it's bugging me. So what color do we want to do here? You know what, just for video's sake, I can either go with a bright red or this stuff. Actually, I use a little bit, but this one's a little more orangey, which is actually really pretty, but I don't know if I want to do the orangey today. I'm on the fence. No, I'm gonna use the other one today. I really like that one. Can you tell? Okay, you know what? I'm not gonna do the brightest red. I'll do a different red. I have so many different types of reds. I got like the brownish ones, the true bright reds, the dark reds. I got tulle. I think I'm gonna use tulle. It's been a little bit since I used tulle. Tulle is the color I'm using for this video. I made up my mind. And that's from ColourPop, ColourPop.com. They're $6 a piece. Shipping, I believe, is like $5. If you're new at ordering from them, like the first two or three times you order from them, you can get $5 off, your order. So it's basically, it's like getting free shipping, essentially. So, but when they show it though, online, if you order it online, it'll actually take the $5 off of one of these. So one of these, if you bought multiples, it'll say $1 instead of $6, but it's like the equivalent of getting free shipping. Okay, so I'm gonna use tulle. This is the wand. It's like a barely spongy wand, and I'm gonna do it for my lip. Now this stuff, yeah, you got to be careful how you apply it, of course, because it's a matte. It's something that's gonna stay for hours, but follow your lip line. I've noticed some ladies on here video wise. I love the YouTubers, don't get me wrong. You know, I do appreciate, you know, the feedback that you guys are sharing with all of us. However, I have noticed some of the ladies have a tendency to not follow their true lip line. So I know they want to make it perfect, which we all do, but you can make it perfect and not like go a little bit less than your lip line. I like going from the true lip line. I think it looks nicer, but I'm a little biased. That's what I prefer. So I apologize in advance, but I like the true lip line. FYI, side note, when you're dealing with ColourPop, before I start, it is the matte one, okay? The liquid matte, ultra matte lipstick. That's the liquid one. Keep in mind, you need to make sure that your lips are ready to go, okay? What I mean by that is sometimes women, their lips are drying or a little chappy. Exfoliate your lips or whatever you need to do to soften up your lips a little bit so that the application's easier for you, okay? Because you really don't need much of this. I would say 1 to 2 coats is sufficient. 3 if max, but I would say 1 to 2 coats. Okay, I wouldn't go over 3. 3 is your max for kneading coats. You really don't need that much. They're very pigmented, but that's fine. So just side note, make sure your lips are prepped ahead of time if you can, okay? It'll make it easier for you. So I'm gonna show you how to put it on. Typically, when you put it on, you know, take your time. If you're new with some of these products, take your time the first couple times just to get accustomed to it so that you're less likely to use as much product and error. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this on. This is tulle, is the color. And this wand's actually great. I know some women don't prefer this wand as much, but honestly, it does the job, so I can't complain. So I just go by my true lip line. Some women go under it, like just before it. I go like the actual lip line. It looks better in my personal opinion. So I guess that depends on the lady. Okay, so I did the lip line. I did a little different than everybody else, that's okay. So I'll go back and I'll actually fill in the rest of my lip. Okay, got some of my teeth boxing. Okay. Okay. Can always go back and if you're not sure about your lip line, kind of take your time with it. Take your time with it. If you're new, take your time with it. Because remember, this stuff dries quickly. It's an ultra matte lip stuff. So I say take your time as far as trying to get it right the first time, because it dries fast, okay? So I just did the bottom part, and that's one layer. It's actually one layer. I just did it in pieces. Now I'm gonna do the top. I try to start up here, catch it up. It's like connecting the dots, but with your lips. I try to do it right the first time. If you have a slight boo-boo, which can happen, use a Q-tip. Q-tip with a little bit of water, on the Q-tip. If you need to, use a Q-tip. Okay. Also, I find the more layers you put on, which you don't want to go crazy with layers, but if you do like two or three layers, this stuff lasts even longer, it seems like. Because I seem like I had to scrub and scrub with soap and water to get the rest of it off. So, I'm filling it in. Get more stuff because I didn't put enough on my wand. Take your time with it. Take your time. Everyone's always in a rush, but something like this, you want to take your time at first. I can take my time because I'm home, so so I'm quick with everything else, and then I take my time with this. I mean, I can do it a little faster, but I just want to show you. The precision on this is great with this wand. So I know some people have a personal preference on the wands with lip stuff, but honestly, I really love this. And I'll show you if I have boo-boo. Which I will, because I was talking while I was doing it. I'll show you. Make sure I filled in the rest of my lip though. Hang on. Because I gotta make sure I got it all. Okay. That's the first layer. You can do the illusion of making your lips bigger by drawing it slightly bigger, slightly over your normal lipstick line. I'm gonna use a Q-tip with water just to slightly smooth over the spot that maybe I went slightly over, that I think I went over. That's okay. I'm telling you, Q-tips are a girl's best friend when it comes to makeup. So, that's basically it. Okay, the lip stuff. I'm just being anal, so don't mind me. A couple teensy-weensy spots that I'm being anal. I guess I'm a little bit of a perfectionist, so I apologize. Okay. If you want to add one more layer, you may, but you see how pigmented it is? I'll add one more layer. I usually don't go more than two layers. Let it dry in between layers, okay? Let it dry first before doing another layer. Okay? Look at that. Isn't that amazing? Pigment's unreal. For the price, you can't beat it. It's $6. Now, I've looked on other sites that do sell it, like eBay or whatever. Honestly, because I'm always looking for where I can get things cheaper, even if it's the same brand. Honestly, it's cheaper to just go straight from ColourPop. versus eBay. Now, once in a while, you might look out, but honestly, it's if you buy in bulk, usually it actually tends to be cheaper through the original people, ColourPop, or like BH Cosmetics. You know, originally from them ends up being cheaper usually versus anywhere else to get it. Okay, unless you have a girlfriend or something who sells it. But yeah, see, look at that, two layers. That was all it was. So I apologize, it took a little more time, but you know, I like to take a little bit more time on something like this that's gonna last for hours. As far as drinks, food, when I drink, I have a tendency to use a straw when I'm at home working, so obviously this is gonna be on for a while. Anyway, food wise, it's actually good with food. You might have a little bit come off, you know, like the inner part, but if you're worried about like your lip liner, that is not even an issue, that will stay there. So if you did have to brush up, it's only like a one-time brush up, okay? So food wise, which is better, ColourPop liquid or BH Cosmetics, the actual lipstick? I would have to say the lipstick. I think because it's a little bit more waxier, it tends to take the food issue better in stride, okay? So ColourPop's really great, don't get me wrong, they're amazing. But food-wise, I think slightly a little bit better is the BH Cosmetics. But this one's so much easier to apply, and it's great. It's lighter, it feels lighter too. So they're all good, they're just different, honestly. So there's that. That was the color tool from ColourPop for anyone who needed a reminder. Okay? Q-tips are your best friend, okay? So, next thing, okay? I apologize if this video is long for me yapping. I'm doing the liquid eyeliner, all May, the spongy tip. I'm just going to do, at first, I'll do the wing. I guess I'll do the winged look. I'll try to just do a simple winged or cat eye. Nothing crazy. I'm not gonna do much today. There's different tips and tricks you can do for this. I just kinda eyeball it. I know it's not perfect, but I can fix it with Q-tip. They say one way it works is a little piece of tape, you know, to get the angle. See, this one actually came out better. But yeah, I mean, that's kind of open to interpretation, what works for you. See, I like this one better. And it's a baby one, it's not even a big one. So let me get my Q-tip to fix this, because it will bug me. See, this is why I love Q-tips. I can erase it or fix it. Let's see here. You got the odd little smudge when you're doing your makeup, your eyeshadow, and let's say you did your eyeshadow makeup and you're trying to put on your mascara. And say your mascara accidentally went on a little bit, slight little dot or blotchiness on your eyeshadow, get a Q-tip. And you don't even have to wet it actually in that instance. I mean, you can. Q-tip. Q-tip helps, it really does. I'm a believer in the Q-tip. Q-tip you can use for a lot of things. Okay, so it just helps. I'm gonna try and go back and fix this real quick, because I am freehanding it, mind you. Some people can freehand it easy. Some people use a spoon. I don't know if you've heard of a spoon method. Where you get a spoon, and the actual spoon part, you put it like this, and then you draw, you know, the line or whatever with the spoon. There's a video of a, I believe an Oriental lady, I don't know her background, who shows it. She tries to be funny and jokey with it. And it does seem to work. So, I mean, that might be something some of you ladies may consider. You have to check on YouTube, see whose methods on how to apply eyeliner, liquid eyeliner, doing the winged look or whatever, what the options are out there, because there's a lot of ways you can go about it. I just freehand it, honestly. But hey, if you need that extra help, look for it. YouTube it. YouTube it, ladies and gentlemen. YouTube it. I'm telling you. I YouTube research all the time. How'd you think I found out about ColourPop? I actually found out about ColourPop specifically through a makeup group. I just randomly joined a makeup group on Facebook because the group originally they were giving away free t-shirts and you would, like makeup saying t-shirts. And the shirt was free, you just paid shipping, which was like $5. So for a shirt, $5. And they had plus size and everything too for the ladies that are concerned about sizing. Basically it went from me getting that to them saying, well, because you got our shirt, you can actually join our group for free. So I joined the group for free and the group like doubled within a 2, 3 months or whatever it is now that I've been with them, quite a few months. And everyone gives free makeup tips and advice, exfoliating tips, makeup tips on like doing fun makeup colors on your face or Halloween makeup, whatever. I'll tell you the name of it. I'll see if I can add the link if possible. I'm gonna do my regular eyeliner down here. For anyone who's wondering, why do I put liquid eyeliner at the bottom versus on the lid? Why do I do it on the lash? Because, and my mom actually used to be a makeup artist back in the day, professionally. And this actually does make sense. This actually helped me. When you do it the way I'm doing it, basically under the lash line versus doing it on your lid, basically your eye doesn't look as small. So that's always a plus. Regardless, if you do the white to make it look bigger or not, to make it pop, that's optional. The white liner they usually do on the lid too, to make your eyes look bigger, or if you're doing that doll makeup for Halloween. But back to my point, I do it here because it makes the eye not look as small. If you do it on your lid, it makes your eye look smaller. And then on top of that, also, basically, I find that my eye isn't irritated. Let me fix this real quick. It's bugging me. So women, if you're running around, or anybody, if you're running around, like a chick with your head cut off, running around doing errands, having a full day from work, whatever, I find that it's easier to have it done this way. Also, because if you get sweaty or icky running around throughout the day, if you do eyeliner, whether it's liquid or the pencil, preferably, I'm talking about the liquid though. If you're doing it on your lid instead, what happens is it'll smudge. It can smudge, I should say. It can smudge, especially if the kind of person has a bad habit of touching your eyes, if your eyes are itchy or whatever. And when it smudges, it'll go in or bleed into your eye, like right under in there in your eye. So, and that can irritate your eye, right? Because it's something foreign going in your eye, essentially. So, to avoid that hassle or any allergic reaction or whatever for sensitive, instead of worrying about that, that's why I do it underneath. So, my eyes don't look as small, and I don't have to worry about the product getting into my eye because it's not there where it can do that. So, it's less likely to occur, basically. Is really the end piece point there is it's less likely to get into your eye. Okay. Now, if and it might do it, might not. Sometimes it does it or not. If you have a little error or issue with your eyeliner, you make a mistake, go back and get another Q-tip with a little water on the tip and just clean it up. Clean it up, soften it up. Maybe you went too thick on the end, like I did here in the front. Clean it up. You can clean it up with a Q-tip. It works. I'm telling you, it works. Cheap, easy way to fix it. Boom. So it's not a total loss. If some of the eyeliner, if you're using a liquid one, it smudges because it's still trying to dry and you blinked a little too early or whatever, go back and get your Q-tip. Go get a Q-tip. Clean it up. Okay? Clean it up. It'll help you out. Okay? Do that. Do that. It helps. Okay? So I just did like a baby cat eye, nothing crazy. For today. But yeah, so that's that. See? So I got my lips in check. I got my eyeliner in check, which I can always fix that a little bit more, but it looks good. Eyebrows, I got eyebrows. Now, mascara. I'm using Maybelline, another good brand to use, a stiletto. The formula is really a glossy finish. If you're someone who likes your eyelashes long but sleek and thin, not thick or cakey or bold, but still really nice, go with the stiletto. If you want it lighter and not so, but still long and nice and sleek and thin, go with the stiletto. Stiletto brand is actually really good. Their liquid eyeliner is very good as well. I just ended up sticking with Almay, but their eyeliner is really good too. They have some glossiness to their formula. It's amazing. But I just ended up sticking with these guys. So, tip when you're using your mascara, rule of thumb, go to the end and go zigzag up. Zigzag up. Sometimes I forget a zigzag, honestly, because I don't need to, because I put on a good amount anyway. But that way, when you do the zigzag, you're getting all the little hairs, the lashes, and avoiding clumps, staying there. If you put a little too much product in your brush, it could cause a potential clumpy. So always just, back and forth, back and forth. You know those, I don't remember what brand it was. It might have been Maybelline or a different brand. You know, they have some mascara that is the vibrating one. The vibrating one is doing what I'm showing you, the going zigzag. So if you're a lazy butt, then yeah, you can spend the extra money, just have a vibrating mascara. But honestly, you really don't need to spend the extra money. Just do it yourself. It's really quick. It's not hard. If you want to go over and do like a second layer on your mascara, if you're confident to do that and you've worked with makeup a long time, know how to work with it, then yeah, go back and do more. You can do it thin, thick, whatever. Whatever there's different styles on eyelashes too. Some people, they have it like manga, how they have it really thick, but they have it like pieces, like not just thin like that. I like to go up top like this just for the ends, to finish the ends, to make sure the ends just get enough love as well. Like I get love too. So there's that, and I'm gonna do the bottom. Now see a little bit of my eyeliner smudge because it wasn't fully dry yet. So I go back with my Q-tips. So if you see me using my Q-tip periodically in the video, it's because I'm just fixing a little quick boo-boo. That was an easy fix. And then you do it downward. Boom. Real easy, real easy. As you get accustomed to it. They say you need to change your mascara every 3 months. I want to say it is every 3 months. You have to double check and then quote me back, but I believe it's every 3 months. I like to do getting two for like the price of one, or buy one get one half off or whatever. I'm all about it. So I'm going to show you before after of the effect this has on my eyelashes. Now, granted, I did it traditional, the traditional way, where it's not too much, not too less, and it's your traditional look. Very traditional. Just to give you a heads up. So let me get my video here, just to show you, if possible. I'm gonna try. I don't know if you can see the difference. This is the eye I just did. I know I'm gonna look creepy, but to show you.
See? Boom, boom, boom. This side, you don't really notice. You don't really notice. This side, it's like, wow, look at them babies. Wow, look. Oh, now you can see it more when I did it like that. It changed the. Look at that. Big difference. Big difference. You can see the lashes already. It's because of the lighting, see? Look at that. Boom. You already see it. Here, it's almost non-existent. I mean, you know I have lashes, but like, you can see the difference. Okay? And this is me just doing it the traditional way.